over 6,500 languages on the planet, and I'm here to share the basics of one of them. This year, I started taking ASL, or American Sign Language classes, and I found it to be a fascinating language. Today, I'm going to share a brief explanation of ASL, how to sign the alphabet in ASL, and some of the alphabet's functions. Google defines language as the method of human communication, either spoken or written, consisting of use of words in a structured or conventional way. This covers most languages, but sign languages are unique. Instead of being an auditory form of communication, they're visual. American Sign Language originated when Laurent Clerc, a French sign language teacher, came over and started merging French Sign Language with some pre-existing native sign language signs. Each country has its own sign language. Just because American Sign Language is in English doesn't mean that it's the only English sign language. It is completely different from British Sign Language. If you look at the French and American Sign Languages, you can see the similarities between the alphabets. To sign the alphabet, you only have to use one hand. It starts like this. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. J is a moving letter, so you start with the I shape and draw a J. K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z is the other moving letter. You just draw the Z shape. So, ASL, or the ASL alphabet, has three main functions in American Sign Language. The first is finger spelling, foods and companies, and anything that might not have a specific sign. So foods like rice, pizza, and barbecue are all finger spelled. And then companies like Ace Hardware, IKEA, and Macy's are all spelled as well. The second purpose is for asking for a sign when you don't understand what someone is signing to you. The third purpose is spelling out names. So Carter,